In this video, what I want to do is show you a really simple way you can use to make AI content sound less AI-like. And I think that this is important to do. And so let me explain what it is that I did. Was actually just had an article written by Rightseed, and it just did a full in-depth article. And let's take a look at that just real quickly right now. All right, so this is the article here. It's 1600 words. And if I just view the text here, this is what it came up with now. This is just completely out of the box guide. And this guides you through, and it basically says the ultimate guide to choosing the best crypto exchange in Canada. Okay. Now, in this first part, to me, this is part of the thing that sounds very AI. Okay. When it says here, the Canadian crypto exchange landscape is a dynamic and rapidly evolving market, a surge operating within its borders, these exchanges, blah, blah, blah. Then again, it goes back to using landscape, the venture into the world of trading is characterized by a diverse range of platforms. So to me, this already feels pretty AI. It doesn't feel very, very authentic. So again, therefore, a comprehensive selection of digital assets can be a significant advantage for a crypto exchange. Furthermore, these are all considerations. Okay. So what I did was I put it in Perplexity. Okay. And I just had one prompt here. I said, rewrite this to sound less AI, vary sentence length and rhythm. Okay. And so this is the exact same article. The landscape is a dynamic and rapidly evolving market. Okay. And this is what it came back with. So it says here, the world of cryptocurrency trading in Canada is growing fast with new platforms emerging to meet the rising demand. Whether you're a seasoned investor or just starting out, picking the right crypto exchange can make all the difference. These platforms act as digital marketplaces where users can buy, sell, and trade cryptocurrencies. I like that a lot better. I'd probably change a couple things here, and this is what you should do with AI just to round things out. But I would use another keyword here instead of these platforms, right? And then Canada's crypto market is diverse, offering everything from globally recognized exchanges to smaller, locally focused platforms. Each comes with its own sets of features, making it, and I get rid of essential, to understand your needs before diving in. And so then it talks about strict laws. And so that's something where you can actually link to something that keeps it in mind. And this has actually made it a lot shorter, the article, which may or may not be good for your purposes. But again, this is how you can prompt and make things better. It actually just picks three of the exchanges. CoinSquare is in the States, but it does. And I believe Kraken, I think, moved out of the States because of regulatory issues. But both of these do accept Canadian investors. That's one of the ones that they allow. And so it actually added some stuff here because the other article didn't have anything specific about the different platforms. So that's one thing. Obviously, I'm going to redo this, but I love the fact that it made this whole part sound much more realistic. So I put it into Copyscape to compare the different pages or articles. And you can see here, this is the original 1700 words. And this is almost half, right? So I might want to try a prompt that says, keep the length or keep the detail or something like that. But when you're just comparing it apples to apples here, as a dynamic and rapidly evolving market, the world of cryptocurrency trading in Canada is growing fast with new platforms emerging to meet the rising demand. It just makes it a lot. This one will be much easier to rewrite and just add a little spin to make it even more realistic, more human and less AI. And if you look at all these different elements here, all these different sections, this is real clunky. Understanding the nuances of this landscape is crucial for anyone looking to venture into the world of cryptocurrency trading in Canada. Versus Canada's crypto market is diverse, offering everything from globally recognized exchanges to smaller, locally focused platforms. So it's just far better as it is. And this was using the non-pro version of Perplexity. So if I was using the pro version, or if I was using DeepSea, then this could even be potentially written better, right? So one key to keep in mind is the prompt that I used here. I'll just go back to that here, right here at the top, which is rewrite this to sound less AI, vary sentence length and rhythm. And I think that's really important as to make your text seem more realistic. Anyhow, I hope this video is helpful. I'll put a link to my AI newsletter in the bottom. I'd love for you to join and let me know if this video was helpful for you or if you got some tips on prompting for making your written text sound less like AI.